فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
The second fiqh that we take from the hadith is the scholars, they differed amongst themselves. Iftaraqat madahibu ahli al-ilm. The scholars, they differed regarding what is meant by yawmu shak, the day of doubt. And there are two strong madhabs, two strong views that are standing on this issue. Two different views. But let's first of all, before we look at what they differ on, let's look at what they agree upon. Both parties agree that the day of Shak is after the 29th of Sha'ban. They all agree that after the 29th of Sha'ban is the day of Yawmul Shak. But they differed whether it is on the 30th of Sha'ban or whether it is on the 1st of Ramadan. Okay? This is the question. Are you with me? And I want you guys to understand this point because it's very important. Before the 29th, we both parties believe, before the 29th, there's no need for looking. On the 28th, 27th, 26th, you don't need to look at anything. Whether the sky is cloudy or not, it doesn't matter. This is not day of Shak. It's Sha'ban. Sha'ban can't be the less than what, 29 nights. The khilaf occurred, if the 29th night comes, the day after, which is the 30th, is that the day which we need to look for Ramadan? Are you with me? Do we look for Ramadan on the 30th night? And is that the day of doubt, where the doubt can come on? And some said, no, it's the first of Ramadan. So those are the two opinions. Are you with me? That is the two opinions. Let's look at the first opinion that stands there, which is Madhab al-Hanabila, the Hanbali Madhab, which is, it is on the 30th of Sha'ban, أَنَّهُ يَوْمُ الثَّلَاثِينَ مِنْ Sha'ban. It is the 30th. إِذَا كَانَتْ لَيْلَةُ صَحْوًا. If the day that the cloud is on the 30th, are you with me? Even if the cloud is clear. Are you with me? وَلَمْ يَرَى الْهِلَالُ. And you don't see the moon.
Clear or cloudy?
No, clear. They say, the first opinion is, it is on the 30th of Sha'ban. It's on the 30th night of Sha'ban. أَنَّهُ مِنْ يَوْمِ الثَّلَاثِينَ مِنْ Sha'ban. إِذَا كَانَتْ لَيْلَةُ صَحْوًا. If the sky is clear. Are you with me? And you don't see the moon. No sighting. It's clear, but you don't sight the moon. They said, فَهَذَا عِنْدَهُمْ هُوَ يَوْمُ الشَّكِّ. This is the day of doubt. الَّذِي يُنْهَى عَلْ صِيَامِ. You're prohibited from fasting. The sky, they said, is clear. And you still can't see the moon. If you fast, then it's haram for you and it is not permissible. Now, we'll listen to the point that they said after that. But they said, أَمَّا إِنْ حَالَ دُونَ رُؤْيَةِ الْهِلَالِ غَيْمٌ أَوْ قَطْرٌ. But they said, if seeing the moon, clouds get in your way, the vision becomes blurry, like there's things between you and it's a very cloudy day. Yeah? Or it's a very dusty day, you see, and the pollution and whatnot. Then they said, فَهَذَا لَيْسَ بِيَوْمُ شَكٍ يُنْهَا عَنْ صِيَامِ. That's not a day where you're prohibited from fasting. You're not. Are you mean? Rather, what they said is, بَلْ يَجِبُ صِيَامُهُ. Rather, they said it's obligatory for you to fast. وَالْحَالُ هَذِهِ. And the situation is like this. احْتِيَاطًا بِنِيَةِ رَمَضَانِ. They said, you have to fast. You have to fast to be on the safe side of fasting. Are you with me? And by the way, this is not just the Hanbali Madhab. Many people assume that it's only the Hanbali Madhab. Rather, this is the view of many of the Sahabas. This is the view of a lot of the Sahabas. And a view of a lot of the tabi'een. This is a view held by Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. His son Abdullah ibn Umar held this view. Amr ibn al-As, he held this view. Abu Huraira, he held this view. Anas ibn Malik, Muawiyah, Aisha, Asma' bint Abi Bakr. He also, Bakr ibn Abdullah al-Muzani, عثمان الهندي ابن أبي مريم مطرف ابن الشخير ميمون بن مهران طاووس بن كيسان مجاهد بن الجبر. I mean, it's a view held by a lot of scholars. Are you with me? Al-Imam al-Mardawi in his Kitab al-Insaf, after he mentioned this first madhab, this first opinion that we just mentioned, which is madhab al-Hanabila, and it's a view held by Umar and Nisan and Amr ibn As and Abu Huraira and Anas and Muawiyah and Aisha and Isma' bint Abi Bakr and Bakr ibn Abdullah al-Muzani and Uthman al-Nahdi, sorry, Ibn Abi Maryam and Mutarrif ibn Shakhir and Maymun ibn Mihran and Tawus ibn Kaysan and Mujahid. After he mentioned that, he said, وَهُوَ الْمَذْهَبُ عِنْدَ الْأَصْحَابِ. This is the view held by the Hanbali scholars within the madhab. وَنَصَرُوهُ وَصَنَّفُوا فِيهِ تَصَانِيفِ. And they gave victory to it. Are you with me? And they authored books to prove this opinion. وَرَدُّوا حُجَّجَ الْمُخَالِفِ. And they refuted the opinions of the opposite opponents. And they said, وَقَالُوا نُصُوصُ أَحْمَدِ تَدُلُّ عَلَيْهِ. And they said that the evidences are on the side of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. Are you with me? And this is from the what? Oh, مِن مُفَرَدَاتِ الْمَذْهَبِ. By the way, as a side benefit, this is one of the things that Imam Ahmad is alone on, and all the three other madhabs don't agree with him on this. Okay, it's the Hanbali madhab. Oh, this is one of the other four, three madhabs are not on this. Are you with me? Very good. What's their hujjah? What's their proof? And what's their argument that they're basing it on? They're saying, وَحُجَّتُهُمْ مَا رَوَى نَافِعٌ. Their hujjah and their proof is مَا رَوَى نَافِعٌ. What Nafi' narrated from Abdullah ibn Umar. Nafi', he narrated from Abdullah ibn Umar that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الشهر تسع وعشرون. The month is 29 nights. فلا تصوموا, do not fast. حتى تروا الهلالة, until you see the moon. ولا تفطروا حتى تروا, and do not break your fasting until you see it. فإن غم عليكم فقدروا له. If it becomes blurry and you can't see it, it's hidden from you, then فَقْدِرُوا لَهُ. We'll speak about the word فَقْدِرُوا لَهُ, which means ضَيِّقُوا لَهُ, restrict it to it then. Okay, we're going to take that word فَقْدِرُوا لَهُ. فَقْدِرُوا لَهُ means أي ضَيِّقُوا لَهُ. So what are they trying to say? If you say restrict it, they mean that فَقْدِرُوا لَهُ, it means restrict it. And if it means restricted, then it means restricted the month of Sha'ban to 29 nights. Restricted to that. And then they argued that, and they said, Abdullah ibn Umar, who's the narrator of this hadith, is the one who took that opinion. Are you with me? They said, Abdullah ibn Umar, who's the narrator of the hadith, wa huwa rawi, he's the narrator of this hadith, he's of the first opinion, which is that the 30th of Sha'ban, even if it's if the cloud is bright and it's and you don't see the moon, then this is the day of doubt. And then they said, since Abdullah ibn Umar holds this view and he's the narrator of the hadith, then they said, وَهُوَ رَاوِيهُ وَأَعْلَمُ بِمَعْنَاهُ فَوَجَّبَ الرُّجُوعُ إِلَىٰ تَفْسِيرِ. The man who narrates the hadith is more knowledgeable than anyone else. His understanding takes precedence over everything. That's a very strong argument. That is a very strong argument, by the way. The second opinion is now. The second opinion is وَهُوَ مَذْهَبُ جُمْهُورِ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ. This is the view of the majority of أَهْلُ الْعِلْمِ. And it's the opinion by the three other remaining أئمة. This is the view held by Abu Hanifa, and Imam Malik, and Imam Shafi'i. All three of them, they hold this view. And it's also a narration that is mentioned from Ahmed. وَهُوَ رِوَايَةَ عَنْ أَحْمَدْ. But it's not the Mu'tamad in the Madhab. You have to realize there's something you have to know. It is a riwayah on Ahmed. There is a narration that's attributed to him. He said this statement, as well, this view as well. But that's not what the Madhab al-Hanabila built their argument on. They, as Ibn al-Mardawi, he mentions in his Kitab al-Insaf. And I'm not a Hanbali, by the way, so I might be wrong on that statement, but my little research told me this. هو رواية عن أحمد. And it's a narration from Imam Ahmed ibn Hanbal. And the yawm al-shak, that the day of doubt, the day of doubt, this is the second opinion, is huwa yawm al-thalathina, it is on the 30th of Sha'ban. إِذَا كَانَتْ لَيْلَةُ فِيهَا غَيْمٌ أَوْ قَتَرٌ حَالَ دُونَ رُؤْيَةِ الْهِلَالِ. They said it's the 30th of Sha'ban. If the night, there is a cloud on it. It's a cloud. For you not to be able to see what? For you to see the moon. There's a cloud, there's something blocking you from it. فَلَا يَدْرِي, the person doesn't know. هَلْ أَهَلَّ هِلَالُ رَمَضَانَ أَمْ لَا. They don't know, has the moon, is it the time to do it or not? They said, فَهَذَا هُوَ يَوْمُ الشَّكِ. That's the day of doubt. الَّذِي يُرْهَى عَوْ سِيَامِهِ, fasting is prohibited, في هذا الحديث, is based on this hadith. أَمَّا أَزْفُرْ, إِذَا كَانَتِ السَّمَاءُ صَحْوًا, if the sky is clear, وَلَمْ يَرَى الْهِلَالُ, and the person doesn't see the moon, فَإِنُوْ لَا يُسَمَّ يَوْمُ الشَّكِ أَصْلًا, that's not even called a day of doubt, أَصَالَةً, at all. It isn't. بَلْ يُجْزَمُ أَنَّهُ مِنْ شَعْبَانِ, rather than we will actually affirm that this is part of Sha'ban. This is part of Sha'ban. وَيُحْرَمُ صَوْمُ, and fasting of it is haram. And they base their argument on this hadith. The arguments that they brought, the Jumhur's argument now. وَحُجَّةِ الْجُمْهُورِ فِي الْمَنِعِ. Has the both opinions become clear to you guys? The argument of the Jumhur, the majority of the scholars, in prohibiting it, مِنْ صِيَامِ يَوْمَ الشَّكِ إِذَا حَالَ دُونَهُ حَائِلْ, is, number one, the hadith of Abu Hurairah, which is marfu' in Bukhari and Muslim, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, صُومُوا لِرُؤْيَتِي, fast in the seeing of the crescent, of the moon. وَأَفْضِرُوا لِرُؤْيَتِي, and break your fast in seeing it. فَإِنْ غُبِيَ عَلَيْكُمْ فَأَكْمِلُوا عِدَّةَ الشَّعْبَانِ ثَلَاثِينَ, if it becomes hidden from you, then complete the month of Sha'ban 30. That's the argument. Are you with me? Mm-hmm. So they said, we base it on what we see. The second one is Hadith Ibn Umar, which is marfu' al-ati ba'dahu fi sahihain wa lafdhu 'inda al-Bukhari, which is ash-shahru 29 layla, the month is 29 nights. Fala tasumu hatta taraw, don't fast until you see it. Fa in umma 'alaykum, if it becomes hidden from you, fa akmilu al-'iddata 30, complete the month 30. And Imam Muslim says, fa in ghumiya 'alaykum faqdulu lahu 30, if it's hidden from you, then complete it to 30. Are you with me? So these narrations are specifically saying 30. It's actually adding to it 30, which the other view that they had, there were 30 wasn't being mentioned. And these ahadith are all saying what? By completing the month in what? Sha'ban, 30 days. If you do not see what? The crescent, due to what? Due to a ghaym. Are you with me? And they said that the Prophet ﷺ prohibited the fasting of the day of doubt. And they said the day of doubt is actually this day. Very good. And they said that the striving of Ibn Abbas is a ijtihadun minhu, is a striving on his side. But it goes against these ahadiths, which are correct and that are authentic. Are you with me? Abdullah ibn Umar, his action that he came with, فَوَ اجْتِهَادٌ مِّنْهُ, it's a striving from him, مُخَالِفٌ لِهَذِي الْأَحَادِيثِ الصَّحِيحَةِ, which is in opposition to these authentic narrations, these clear-cut authentic narrations that order us to finish the month on 30 days. If we do not see the crescent, based on it being unclear. Good. The third argument that they also based their evidence is the hadith that we took before, the hadith of Abu Hurairah, which the Prophet ﷺ said, that he negated from a person to fast a day or two before Ramadan. They used that as their argument. And so they said, Ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and your argument was to be on the safe side. Are you with me? And you're not allowed to fast a day or two before Ramadan. Are you with me? So, and Allah knows best. Allahu tabarak wa ta'ala, He knows best. The second opinion seems stronger. وَلَعَلَّ هَذَا هُوَ الْأَقْرَبُ لِلصَّوَابِ. Because the Prophet's statement takes precedence over everything. And because of that, Ibn al-Qayyim, Ibn Taymiyyah, A'immatul Da'wah al-Najdiyyah, A'immatul Da'wah, Muhammad Abdul Wahhab and his ahfad, his grandchildren, all of them, rahimahumullah, may Allah have mercy upon them. Are you with me? Al-Sheikh Muhammad Ibrahim, Al-Sheikh Abdul Rahman Nasir al-Saudi, Al-Sheikh Abdul Aziz ibn Baz, Al-Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen, and other than them, they all took the opinion, the second view. If you want to see more into this issue, go to the Majmu' by Nawawi, Al-Mughni ibn Qudama, Zadu al-Mi'ad fi Hadi Khayr al-Ibad by Ibn al-Qayyim, Rawd al-Murbi'. If you want, go to the Tanwir al-Maqala fi Halli al-Fadhi al-Risala by Ibn Khalil al-Maliki. If you also want, you can go to the Minah al-Shifa by Lil Buhuti, which is a Hanbali book. If you want Al-Insaf fi Ma'rifat al-Rajih min al-Khilaf, حاشية ابن عابدين حاشية ابن قاسم على روض المربع مجموع فتاوى ابن باز توضيح الأحكام لابن بسام and الشرح الممتع للشيخ الشيخ ابن عثيمين رحمه الله تعالى. The last إن شاء الله تعالى فقه that we take from the hadith, the last إن شاء الله تعالى, which is في حكم صوم يوم الشك على تعريف الراجع عند الجمهور. What is the ruling now? If a person chooses to fast the day where there is doubt, since we took the second opinion, and we chose that inshallah ta'ala, which is the view of the Jumhur, what is the ruling if a person fasts? Zahirul hadithi, from the apparent of the hadith, is what? Tahreemu, that it's haram. إِذِ الْمَعْصِيَةُ لَا تَكُونِ إِلَّا عَلَى فِعْلٍ مُحَرَّمٍ. And since we strengthened, based on the previous hadith of Abu Huraira, that the nahi, that the Prophet ﷺ said, لا تقدم رمضان بصوم يوم أو يومين إلا من كان صائما فليصومه. Yeah? That hadith, we said that the negation here is based on what? للتحريم. So this would fall under, if you fast a day or two before it, which you think is a day of doubt, then the prohibition will fall under it and it's haram. And we said, if it's haram, what does a person get? آثِمُ بِفِعْلِهِ. By doing it, you become a sin. وَبُطْلَانِ الْعَمَلِ. You're a sinner by doing that action, and also that action is null and void. It is what? It is null and void. And that is the opinion, brothers, held by who? That is the opinion held by the أئمَّةُ الثَّلَاثَة, أبي حنيفة, مالك, and شافعي. And it's also a riwayah of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, which he chose, rahimahullah. There's also another opinion that says it's disliked, but we say that النهي تقتضي التحريم, that the negation, it benefits us what? Prohibition. Okay? That we're not allowed to do it unless there comes a textual evidence that diverts it from its apparent. And we'll stop there inshallah ta'ala. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.